how excited are you to be on the red carpet for the BAFTA Film Awards 2018?
Yeah, to be honest, this is my first time at the BAFTAs. So to be here is an honour, and the fact that I'm working with E is very exciting. And yeah, I mean, look at it. It's like an insane red carpet, so I'm pretty excited.
Are there particular films or particular stars that you're especially hoping to see tonight or got your fingers crossed for?
Yeah, I am a big fan of Three Billboards. I saw it when it came out, and I just have a lot of love for that film, and I thought everything about it was amazing. And I think I want him to win Best Support Act, so fingers crossed for that film.
And obviously, Three Billboards has been mopping up at a lot of the award ceremonies. Why do you think that is? Why do you think that it's connected with an audience, particularly this time, so much?
I think it's something quite fresh. Like, this is such a simple story, but the characters are so brilliant throughout the film. I think it really connects with the audience. I think people can relate to it a lot. So it felt very fresh to me.
Of course, like many of our attendees tonight, you are wearing black. Why was that an important statement for you?
Well, I think it's obviously the whole industry, what's been going on with the Time's Up campaign, and just trying to speak out about it and raise awareness and support the people that are going through or have gone through times like that, really. So, yeah, that's what.
I think that particularly when we look at YouTube as a platform, there are changes that maybe need to be made in that arena specifically.
Yeah, I mean, YouTube's hard to kind of keep ties on things because it's so big, it's such a global platform, and it's so instant, you know? So it is hard to stay on top of things. But yeah, I mean, obviously there's been a lot of controversy being on YouTube recently, and I think they have been kind of on it to improve that moving forwards.
Talking about moving forward yourself, what have you got coming up the rest of 2018? Always busy and lots of exciting stuff, I'm sure.
Yeah, so I'm actually doing a lot of writing at the moment. So I'm writing a couple of shows. So they're going into production, which is quite exciting. And yeah, I'm just really excited for this year. I'm in a really good place. I'm happy.
In terms of those shows, can you tell us anything, just roughly what genre they are, that kind of stuff?
I can't give, yeah. Top secret right now. But yeah, the stuff will come, but maybe a long time in the future.
I mean, obviously, like all YouTubers, as you get busier off-platform, is it hard to maintain your existing channel? Or, I mean, where do you see those priorities for you going forward?
Yeah, I think it's more just stay having fun with it. Like, if you can open up opportunities around YouTube, great. But always look at YouTube as, you know, you came from YouTube and it's a place to showcase what you can do. And that's how I'm looking at it and just treating it as fun now. So, yeah.
Before I let you go, every time we talk to you, we always have to ask about your anti-bullying work because we really appreciate that, and I know a lot of your fans do as well. Have you got anything coming up with that this year? And obviously that's, I assume, still a very important cause for you.
Yeah, there's nothing, I'm not tied into any events of them coming up, but last year I supported them a lot. The year before, I always support them socially. I just haven't been involved in any of their campaigns so far this year, but I'm always supporting as much as I can online and with my presence that way.
Final question, you've got a message to fans before you leave us.
Thanks for continuing to watch my videos. I'm very excited for this year and the future, so thank you.